Thank you, Mr. President. My name is Eyinnaya Abaribe, and I represent Abia South. Thank you, the leader of government business.
Leader, can you switch off your mic, please, so that we can hear him well?
For this administration, but I need to point out that some of the things that you have said in this lead paper, we need to dispute it. This administration cannot be said to be the one that is most economically jinxed since the beginning of this country. That is a fact that we cannot agree with. But beyond that,
Minority leader.
Mr. President, that is not the point. The point really is that I agree with.
Minority leader, you have 4 more minutes to go.
I agree with the leader. Actually, he made a very, very interesting position. He says that we are in interesting, difficult, and tumultuous times, and a time for sober judgment, reflection, and statecraft. This is in his paper. I totally agree with you. And what does that mean for us? What it means for us is that that will lead an administration to ensure that whatever it does actually will be not a time for tokenism, not a time to just go ahead and say something that is simplistic and that does not lead us anywhere. It is a time, Mr. President, for us to build, and not a time for us to build without foundation. And I'm going to go ahead, Mr. President, to say most of the things that are in this budget that we need to very well consider. This budget proposal from this administration says something that is very critical for each and every one of us to know. It seems that the government does not have an overarching view of what it needs to do with this economy. Secondly, it seems also that this government is insensitive to the Nigerian public, increasing taxes and making sure that everything that we do, we want to tax everyone out of our lives, as we see. Now, Mr. President, this government, this budget is nothing but the same. And I'm just going to prove it in a very few minutes. In 2016, Mr. President, let us look at what this government had put as its budget. The budget of 2016 was 3.65, revenue of 3.65, and at the end of the year, we had a revenue performance of, in 2016, of 32%. In 2017, instead of trying to readjust to the reality, we still went ahead and did the same thing, which is exactly what we're doing today. Put bogus figures, and then we were in 2017, we still had a whopping 53% shortfall in our revenue. That means that if every year since 2016, we have always had a whopping 50% less revenue than we project. What we have put today, a revenue of 7.5 or 7.6 trillion, we're also not going to be able to realize that. That means that we're going to realize about 38% of the projected revenue. If that is what is going to be, the government, the budget is already at fault. It cannot take us to where we want to go. Now, what we want is that we have a budget that is based on realistic expectations. This budget is based on, oh, we're going to sell assets, we're going to have all the agencies of government make more money and all that. That is unrealistic, totally unrealistic. And we are not also so sure what the oil situation is going to be. No, I cannot be confined to the
same. Mr. Minority Leader, let me remind you that debt estimates is an estimate. And assumptions, and that is what everybody does from 1999 when we came to this National Assembly. And that is what it will be, what it will continue to be. So I think concentrate on those things that you think we can do to make this budget perform optimally.
If the budget is based on an assumption, which you say, I agree with you, but why are you not assuming properly? Why are you also assuming the wrong thing? So we're also going to look at the assumptions and assume that you know what you're assuming about. So we want to go ahead and say that this 2021 budget does not reflect an understanding of the fundamental challenges that beset this country. If it reflected it, it would not be like this. We won't budget for what we know that we're not going to see. How would you budget 100% knowing that you're going to get only 30%? And how can we have a budget? Every year we have a budget in which the capital budget and the debt are almost equal. What does that tell us? How do we go forward from there? So, Mr. President, I will leave some of my colleagues to still speak on this budget, but I can say only one thing. This budget is nothing but what Fela has said. Old news. Every time the same old news. Nothing new.
Well, thank you very much for that. Distinguished colleagues, let me thank you very much, the elder in the Senate. No temptation. The deputy chief whip.